make your rounds. I be coming with the pain, stress on my face, getting out the space of the negative. But I put a picture on a frame, coming out the dark, niggas gonna know my name. Joey Go 24K, searching for plenty more cake. That's 24/7 more, many more every yo mate. How I be the nigga with the glow, still taking for me.
Oh man, that's pretty funny. That was funny. Did you guys hear the this is off on a tangent, but I just read it earlier. The story of ODB making Honey with Mariah.
That shit was amazing.
No, but I'm sure it's probably the best story I've ever
heard. It was amazing.
And there's their footage of this.
Did you hear it?
No.
Only me and Parks? All right, nope, now I'm gonna find it. Nope. Hold up. That was funny.
They need a video of them in the studio making that record.
She any story there. I've heard of ODB doing anything. That's hilarious. True.
Here we go. You ready?
I'm ready.
I'll try to read quickly. This gentleman says, Rooney, let me not do that. He says, I reached out to ODB and he wanted $15,000 to rap on the record. At the time, that was a lot of money, but it really wasn't for Mariah Carey's budget. So, no problem. He finally showed up 3 hours late, and when he got there, it was about 10:30 at night. He had been drinking and was on the phone when he walked in, irate, screaming at some girl how he's going to come kill her. He's going to kick her ass, and then whispering, I love you. Then screaming again. This went on for an hour. No judgment here. He finally came out and was like, yo, pardon me. This bitch is driving me crazy. I need some Moet and some Newports before we get into this record. I said.
I want to stop at him and say, pardon me, everyone. As like a nice gesture. This bitch is wild.
I said, it's 12:30 at night, bro. I don't know where we're going to get Moet from. He started yelling at the assistants, calling them white devils, saying, you white devils, y'all don't want black people to have shit. They went out for like an hour, and the only thing they could find was some Heinekens. He was so disgusted, he threw a bottle on the floor. Sounds like a Rory, wild Rory rage
rant. That's like a Rory the year. Like.
Yeah, Rory's been there. No judgment from him.
Throwing bottles.
At this point, Mariah had been calling every hour and hour wanting to hear something over the phone. Tommy was pissed because Mariah was keeping him up, so he finally got on the phone with ODB, and after that, finally we started to record. He said one line, me and Mariah go back like babies and pacifiers, then paused, said, yo, I need to take a break, and then went to sleep for 45 minutes. He woke up and was like, yo, let me hear what I did so far.
Wait. Yo, waking up saying, let me hear what I did so far for too far.
But everybody has done that.
Have you heard your album?
But everybody's done that. We played his one line back. He sang another line or two and then slept for another hour. He would come up with a line, punch that in, go to sleep. He went to sleep three different times in the middle of trying to get that one verse done. If you listen to the record now on his verse, you can hear it's punched in pieces. He actually told the engineer, y'all better have y'all shit together and record it right, because I'm not doing it twice.
That might be the greatest fucking story ever.
It's not finished.
Oh, shit.
There's more.
I stayed in the studio until we finished it. So I was sleeping in the studio when Tommy and Mariah called me, and they said they loved the record. But Tommy had a bright idea. Let's get ODB back in the studio, and instead of just New York in the house, do a line for all the cities. I said, you've got to be kidding me. Of course, ODB wanted another 15 grand. He came back to the studio, a little more mellow, but dead tired. He's sitting there picking food out of his teeth. He pulled a piece of food out of his mouth so big it was scary. I was like, how long did you walk around with that food in your mouth? Like, it was unbelievable. Then he fell asleep on the couch, kicked one of his shoes off. His foot smelled so bad, we had to let him sleep and leave the control room. Eventually, we got the other parts done, and that was that. And I thought the story was over.
There's more.
A week later, it was time to shoot a video. We reached out to him, and he wanted another 15 grand.
Sounds about right.
No problem. So I sent a car to his house, and he drank every friggin' thing in the limo. Showed up at Rye Playland in New York and went to his trailer. I asked him, do you need the stylist to buy clothes for you? He said, nah, this is hip hop. I'm just rocking some jeans and Tim's.
Right.
That day he was in a trailer, in and out of consciousness, when I said, we're getting ready to do a scene. He said, I don't got no clothes. how am I going to do a video if I ain't got nothing to wear? I started screaming at him. Yo, is this not the greatest ODB story in the world?
Shit ever, man.
Tommy told us, take my corporate credit card to the mall. Old Dirty disappeared for a minute, and we found him in a store trying to buy Louis Vuitton luggage. He said, I'm going to use it for a scene.
The luggage.
Yeah.
That luggage never made it.
He came back on the set with all these bags of Tommy Hilfiger clothes and Timberlands. It was finally time for him to do the scene, and I promise you, he put on a pair of jeans and Timbs and said, I'm not going to wear a shirt. I don't need clothes. I wanted to shoot him. Well, that was it for the most part. I have an idea. I want to tie up the clown. Oh, shit. I have an idea. I want to tie up the clown. Plus, Mariah turned him on to peach schnapps, which she always used to drink. He drank like two bottles. So between the hot sun and him drinking two bottles was disastrous that day. Whatever, whatever. So, yeah, that was cool.
Nope.
I thought that was a great story.
So what's up? We calling JoJo?
Rest in peace,
who told
though,
that?
Call her.
Yeah, but I pulled up the Reddit secrets.
Oh, no. Let's hear the white boy Reddit.
Yeah, let me hear this. Because what are you talking about? What is this Reddit secrets?
Yo, I just said I've been reading everything on the internet since 99. I don't know how I find this stuff. This stuff was just floating around. But, man, once you get to reading, you just got to keep reading.
So the white boys are doing what?
There's a thread on Reddit where people are giving up like secrets that could change their life if someone found out.
Okay.
Okay.
And it's mad of them. So I'll read a few of them.
Like anonymously they're saying?
Anonymously, yeah.
Oh, got you.
Here it is. This anonymous person here says, when I was 15, my parents were going through a divorce. My mom worked night shifts and my dad was living with a friend of his. One night, my sister, who was 19 at the time, came home pretty drunk from a party. She was acting goofy and fell on the couch next to me. She started grabbing my leg and laughing, and we started fondling.
Okay.
We ended up having sex right there.
Oh, come on.
Oh, no. This is the first paragraph.
How did you know they were white?
We ended up having sex right there. When we woke up the next day, she had no recollection of the night before, so I just kept my mouth shut. Fast forward to when I'm 18. Sister's home from college. Dad's over for a visit.
They get it. Don't put that voice on this. You sick fuck.
Dad's over.
Hey, you're in trouble now, Carol.
Oh my
God. Wait, Dad's over for a visit. They get into an argument, and in a fit of rage, my dad announces how he's never forgiven her for the abortion she got when she was 19 and subsequently killing his grandchild. He's very religious. And then I realized the baby she aborted was in fact mine. And as far as I know, I'm the only one. Pardon me. I'm the only one who knows since she's never mentioned that night.
This is also Reddit where people would just be saying shit to say it.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Well,
I hope so.
Well, here's another one.
Oh, the sister came back and was like, nah, that was his?
No, it's just mad more stories.
Okay.
Let's hear this guy's. He says, and he starts with a bang, I accidentally killed 7 people.
I hate when that happens.
I put a rag into a new water heater exhaust to keep debris out and installed it in a rental. I get a call a week later. There's been an accident. I show up and there's a ton of EMS and police. They ask me where the gas shutoff is and I go down to shut the gas off and see the end of the rag I forgot sticking out of the top of the heater. Rip the rag out, shut the gas off, and head upstairs, only to be told all the tenants were dead. I drink all day now and sleep.
This is dark.
It's killing.
Reddit
it's,
is dark
and disturbing. Wait,
it's killing me from the inside every single day. But if I say anything, my family is ruined. We have mad rental properties, and we'd be shut down.
Oh, that's what you're worried of?
That's crazy. That sounds like it could be true. That's the wild part about that.
Or, that's fucked.
Can't they look up IP addresses and shit? Like, couldn't you find that person?
I'm just telling y'all some of the stories I'm reading here.
Did you participate in the thread?
Look, here's another one. I'm white and my wife is half black. I fantasize that she's my slave when we have sex. She thinks I'm the least racist person she's ever known.
Jesus Christ.
Should I keep going?
No.
Yeah, yo, you can leave that one right
such,
there.
Y'all are such pansies.
Look what Joe be reading in his downtime.
And people surprised still.
Reddit massacres.
That's the name of the thread. I'm tired.
Speaking of new things, pause. But I found this great new underwear brand. Have you guys heard of MeUndies?
MeUndies? It sounds like an Australian brand.
And there goes the bag.
don't touch MeUndies. Leave MeUndies alone, please.
If they're paying us.
Don't touch. Who took MeUndies?
Joe, do you know anything about MeUndies?
Y'all laughing, but I really like this.
I forgot MeUndies.
We hoping that the chicks forget MeUndies at the pool party. Well, y'all shut up, man. If you've been settling for store-bought underwear 5-packs, I have something that'll change your life for the better. MeUndies. What is MeUndies, you ask? Oh, just seriously soft, feel-good undies delivered right to your door. MeUndies are designed in L.A. and made from sustainably sourced micromodal, a fabric 3 times softer than cotton. MeUndies, softer than soft, luxe undies come in ever-changing selection of classic colors, bold shades, and adventurous patterns so you can tailor your undies to your own personal style. And guess what, Rory and Maul?
What's that?
Maul?
Yes.
You can save time and money each month with a monthly subscription.
Damn, they asking for a lot, man. What they paying? Damn, they doing a whole lot of plugging me on. Hey, where's me money?
Where's me money?
Wait, where the hell?
Things, in fact, did progress, especially with Yandy and Erica. Who really had Mendici's heart? How did Yandy and Erica end up with sons only 10 months apart?
Yo.
How tangled did the web get?
Where's me monies is fucking hilarious, man.
And if you're not ready for a subscription, that's okay. You can still save. That's because MeUndies is offering you 20% off your first pair. Just use your special URL, MeUndies.com/Joe. That's J-O-E. And get 20% off your first pair. So go ahead, revamp your underwear drawer. You deserve it. Once again, that's MeUndies.com/Joe. MeUndies.com/Joe.
I like it.
Yeah, what you want me to do?
That was great, man.
No. I can't Joe say. Biden. They did send us. Phone. They sent us some shit, and it was really good.
Listen, they sent me. I got some. Listen, they gave these things to Rory, and Rory was in charge of the dispersing of them. So I got some wild freak boy color purple. I got some purple MeUndies. Yeah, because Rory got yours, his, Sam's. He just kept everybody's
Kaz
shit.
Kaz probably got mine.
Yeah, come on. Kaz running around hitting Palooza and Maul's MeUndies. Yo, Kaz, you gotta knock it the fuck off.
Give me my undies, bitch. Yeah, give me undies, dog.
We was at the Wale show. I didn't want to give Maul some draws at the Wale show.
Yeah, that would have been crazy. Yeah, can't do that.
That's kind of nuts. But I love them MeUndies.
Nah, the lounge pants are fire.
Yeah, I want MeUndies, man.
Definitely check
Rory,
those
give
out.
Me MeUndies, man.
Everything. Wait, I do want to ask. Right.
I got you, fam.
Oh, is that all we got there? Oh, are we done? So Ghost on Twitter, who I followed after I was going to fight him a few years ago. I was flying to Atlanta to fight Ghost.
Wait. I need that back. So question, when you buy a flight to fight somebody, do you like look for a good rate or are you just booking the first one you see?
You want a good rate.
You want a good rate.
Yeah,
too.
You don't
want
to pay a lot.
But what if you fly?
You need leg room just in case.
Fight somebody, get washed.
Yeah, and he park you.
Well, that's why I didn't fly out there.
Okay.
Because it's probably not smart to fight somebody, a stranger on their territory. Anyway. Yeah,
when they have time to prep.
Atlanta. Yeah. Yo, you better go and make sure you prepared in 36 hours because I will be there. Yeah. That's not really the move. But anyway, so his name popped up in the news recently because he borrowed $75 from a girl, a young lady. And didn't return it, and she was angry about it. So she exposed some private text messages between the two of them.
Over $75?
Yeah. So let me just say, ladies and gentlemen out there, you should not lend money that you need back. You shouldn't lend it. That should be your rule of thumb. Yeah. Don't lend it if you can't afford to lend it. Let me say.
Listen,
that.
Listen, man, you can't air somebody out over $75. I'm sorry. That's fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, great. But wait.
I wasn't really interested in that story outside of him and I our almost fight a few years ago, but I read it and I just ignored it. But then the lady kept putting out more texts, so I read them.
And then that's when my mentions
and
started
I saved up. I saved the text because it was too juicy. I thought she might delete it. So I'm here to read you the text to see if. Are y'all familiar with the story?
No.
Good. I'm so glad.
Oh no,
good.
I
Jory, please. I'm the A mic. I wanna put my A mic shit in effect. I want to mute Rory's mic until the appropriate time.
Got you.
Parks and Maul, I wanna read y'all this slew of texts and see if y'all can figure out the point that I became interested.
Okay.
Here we go.
If Rory names pops up in this, this is going to be the greatest story ever. That's all I'm saying.
It doesn't, but it does.
The young lady says, hey, where's my $75?
Yo. Getting right to the point.
Yo, I hate when girls text you and get right to the point. Like, you got to slow walk the dog in my text.
That means they're ready to
don't let me look down in my phone and see the exact reason why you're texting me immediately. Say good morning, how I'm doing, or something. She said, hey, where's my $75, man? And Ghost, whose name is Sean, and I'm only saying that because it's here, he said, it'll be in your PayPal tomorrow. Question to you guys. Doesn't that sound like it ends it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Question to you guys. Cool. Does that sound like it ends it? If you're talking to an emotional woman?
No.
Not at all. So you guys, let me keep going. She says, because you've hit me every morning since I've been here. Early in the morning, today you didn't, and I really don't want to hear no other excuse. Because if you don't have your car yet, you still have my 75. And honestly, you can send that back. I said, before I leave. Mm-hmm. He said, yeah, before you leave.
Right. Me and she's not leaving yet.
No, I'll get it to you. Before you leave, I'll get it to you. Like, get off my phone. Why are you still on my phone? Yo, and I'm reading it this way because men and women really have a hard time understanding each other. Mm-hmm. And since I'm a man, I'm fighting for the men on this one. She says, I leave at 6 a.m. I thought she had him there. Mm-hmm. He said, if I had your $75 right now, I would have just sent it to you. If I had it since Friday, I would have just sent it to you. Don't know if you just want to argue with me or if you're accusing me of lying, but either way, it's unnecessary. And the money should clear at around 3 a.m.
The 75 should clear.
The bank has to check that one out.
I want y'all to understand that we talking about 75. We talking about three dubs.
This conversation is already too long.
We talking about three dubs and some change. Like, I just want to make sure it's
three dubs and some change. A 10 and a 5.
Listen,
once there's a 5,
the 75 will clear is crazy. Yeah,
actually, you should just give them the 80.
Yeah. Send the 4 dubs and get it over with. Like,
but Ma, don't do that.
Because, why?
Because, and Sin asked me this too. Some people do not have $75, and you can't sound like to spare. It's tough out there. It's tough out there.
Okay.
It's tough out there.
I get that.
I'm with you.
I bought it for a reason.
Yes. Yes. Come on, Maul.
No, his.
Come on, Maul.
I'm mad at his dialogue.
I thought he was bodying the dialogue.
It will clear.
Yeah.
You can't ever tell me $75 is going to clear.
I'm not having a dialogue over $75.
Yeah, like, hold on.
Don't have dialogue.
Bank of America called me, asked me what it was for.
Yeah, like, get the fuck out.
Yeah, I ain't going to lie. $75.
That's what I'm saying. I got a notification on my text.
Did you authorize this? Send the fucking 75 through, man.
Hey, yo, $75 should clear in the next 5 minutes. Right? Yeah, like, I don't even know what you mean. They don't need hours to verify your 75
at
bones.
Like, at all.
Oh, Ghost, you're great, man. All right, so let me finish because there's more. I didn't even get to the good part.
Oh, yeah, God. No, that's the setup.
All right.
This is crazy.
All right. Oh, he says, and yes, I have my car. He gave her, he called her a bitch in his head after that one. He didn't write that, but he said. And she said, listen. Oh. Yo, when bitches start with listen, you're in trouble, my nigga.
First of all, listen to a text is crazy.
I'm the king of that. I'm the king of listening to the text. Yeah, that lets you know I mean business. She says, listen, you bought a Deuce Palooza ticket. Mm. You've hung out, chilled with your people. Mm-hmm. Cool. I sent the 75 because I asked you to pick me up from the airport, which you clearly couldn't do, so I took a cab. I don't care about anything else. Bar it. I want my money by midnight. Mm. Ghost says. Hey, at Dos Rivers bought me a ticket. At Chef Waits got me a VIP band. Midnight, question mark. Are you giving me an ultimatum about $75?
Seriously? That's what it sounds like.
Question mark. Then she said, you told me I would have it by Friday. You've danced around it, my nigga. The principle is you didn't keep your word. So now, when chicks use shit like the principle, you beat. You fuck. You fuck this chick, Ghost. Because she's talking about the principle.
Yeah, that's true.
He said, all right, I'm done. Did I get my car booted? You sent me money to get the boot off. The other money you sent me was for your weed.
Hold on. I want to add another curveball.
Yes, Ghost. Talk your shit, Ghost.
This woman is married.
Wow. Oh,
wait.
Shit.
What? Yes. Wait, no.
This isn't like, no, she said this on the timeline.
Well, pause this. Because I want to come back to this. So okay. Let me finish reading
just
this.
Keep
and
that
I want to get into you. No.
Where can you get a boot off your car for $75?
Where can you get a married woman to send you $75?
Atlanta.
I got to move to Atlanta.
Man, me
that's
too.
Crazy. I don't even have a car.
She said, it's my money. I don't care if it was $2. LOL. IDC. LOL. Back to back LOLs. You're lying. You're not LOLing. He says, I didn't expect to get my car booted in the middle of the work week, Tawana. And I didn't know how much my check was going to be. Relax. She says, that's fine. I don't care. I only care about my $75. So that's caring, Tawana. She said, hit me once you send it. He said, I literally don't have any money. But I'm hustling to get more right now. You'll get the notification. No need to hit you. You obviously don't give a fuck about anything else besides me paying you back. Good try there, Ghost. I've tried that trick back in the day when you get them to act like they only care about one thing that's pretty materialistic and shallow and not about your needs while you're in a time of desperation. Hey, clap it up for Ghost on that one.
That's an OG move. Make yourself vulnerable.
Yeah. You got to do that, especially when they beefing about something.
Yeah.
I'm not mad at that. Oh, she says, you were at Duce Palooza partying yesterday telling me you don't have it today. You're right. I don't. Thanks.
Listen, in Ghost defense, the Duce is free at Duce Palooza.
There you go.
I don't like a chick just clocking all my moves while I'm at Duce trying to lounge.
Trying to lounge?
Yeah, like I'm at Duce trying to get the pressures of the world off me, and here they are also in Duce Palooza.
Right.
You about to ruin my fucking great time here with my friends and trying to bag these fine Atlanta bitches over $75, ma?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, so let me finish.
She got to be fine.
So he says, why'd you say that? And she said, Have fun eating some. I don't know what that means. He said, man, fuck that. I'm not eating any more of that shit.
What's it?
She showed an old tweet. This is old. LOL, did the money clear yet? He says, I'll check. Sorry, I've been in a daze playing FIFA with Dose. He gives a lot of information to people.
That's a lot.
She asked, did the money clear? You telling her you playing FIFA with your friend.
With Dose.
Yeah, Dose don't even sound like he's encouraging you to pay her back.
And gave everyone's Twitter names before.
That was a little odd, a text.
Yeah, how old is this nigga?
She says, okay, and then this is the classy. This is the most classicest of them all, this move right here.
Let's hear it.
He then sent a picture of his empty bank account.
Swag.
$2.89. Rory's seen this, so I won't show him.
I'm familiar.
Hey, Ghost, let me hit the round of applause really low for you one time.
For the $2?
All niggas got that spare empty bank account. Yo.
The 289.
Everybody got that bank account that's got 289 in it. Yeah.
From that old bank that don't even exist.
Yeah.
Sam,
you got to keep it there. The bank that lets you pay on an underdraft.
Yeah.
Like when the money's not really there. Yeah, we got it, Ghost. Slick move there. So I want to dab him for that. Now, to Rory's point. No, I didn't know that this chick was married, Rory. You're telling me this girl's married?
She revealed that information on the timeline.
So a married woman is sending a man money.
The story has gotten
deeper. And what she was saying, she is just friends with this gentleman and you can't send your friend money.
Nah.
They didn't sound like friends.
That doesn't sound friendly.
And I don't care if it's a man or a woman. Man. If you're married, you probably have a joint account. Don't fucking send somebody $75 to get the boot off their car.
Yeah, no.
Don't send no man.
Yo, let's talk about this. Hold up. Hold up. Let's get into it. This is where these Twitter niggas get weird. She's married, right? And she sent a nigga from Twitter $75.
Yeah, like.
What am I doing if I'm her husband?
Stealing $75 out of
her. I had an issue with that if I'm her husband, number one. Number two, anybody read her bio?
No, I didn't read it.
Nah.
It's a personal chef.
Oh, my God.
So that left me even more confused as to why a chick that has personal chef in her bio would be behaving this way. Who the fuck is hiring you to cook? You spilling all the business over 75 bones.
Word. Four dubs.
Chef John would never.
Someone never. Or Chef Corey.
Even,
none of them.
Even through their breakup.
None of them. Yo, he
he's
would,
been quiet.
No. He cares about me. Post breakup. That's hard when you avoid a chick you owe money to the whole night. Man, clap it up for the
nigga. Yo, $75 is crazy.
I'm not answering those texts.
Yo.
And I'm not paying her $75 just because you're annoying about it. If you would just leave me alone, I'd have gave it to you. Because the money cleared.
$75 clearing is crazy.
But Maul, you don't remember the time where you didn't have passive income.
Yeah, but I'm not saying it didn't clear.
I just said $75 is passive income.
$75
is that income?
Right, I'm out of here.
It
man.
Didn't clear.
That's
when does $75 clear?
I don't know.
I don't know if I'm offering to pick a chick up at the airport if I have $2.89 in my account, though.
Fam, this is what I'm saying. There's too much shit going on in this story, man.
Oh, wait, time out. Wait, I'm sorry. Then another chick came out and attacked Ghost.
He owed another $75?
Said that she went on a date with Ghost.
And he forgot his wallet.
At the end of the date, he said, hey, forgot my wallet at home.
Yo, Ghost.
can you do me a favor? Go ahead and pay for both of these meals. Swag. Young lady said that she had the check come. She paid for her meal. She got the fuck out of there on Ghost. left them there. Oh, told the waiter that, hey, this gentleman needs to pay for his items.
His items.
Yeah, once you got to pull out words like items that the check arriving.
My side of mash is not an
what
item.
What happens when that happens? Bad. You got to like do dishes?
I try to avoid those people. The people that want to itemize the
do
check.
Do dishes? Oh, you're going to jail. Nigga, this ain't 1988. You're going to jail
over
if you
$40?
Can. Yes.
I didn't sign a contract. I just said, yo, let me get some of that shit you got.
Okay. Try it. Well, it might be different for y'all too, gentlemen. But they're going to lock my black ass up. I know that for sure.
But that's exactly why I won't
my
go
father
to
owns the restaurant.
Why I won't go to Duce Palooza, though. Because if it's niggas dead without $75, I'm not going. That's
yeah,
me.
I don't want to party with
I'm
niggas
not partying
waiting
with a
for
nigga
the 75 to clear.
Yeah.
Well, then it brings me back to how many people have lied to Fat Man Scoop saying how much money they had in their pocket.
Oh, the big people have always lied. People have always lied.
People always lied to Fat Man. Who's fucking tonight? Who's fucking? I used to always raise my hand when I wasn't fucking.
And you would look
tonight.
Around at the chicks that were screaming.
I was never fucking the night that Fat Man Scoop
never.
Asked. Never. I was a virgin.
That Fat Man Scoop asked if I was fucking that night.
I was nowhere near pussy when he asked.
Yeah, definitely not. You saw that.
Okay.
That
the game,
I don't think I won. It's simple.
Are we going to read an excerpt from King Gucci?
Yeah.
Gucci has a book. That
Joe had this book.
Yes, I have the book because I'm going to read it.
So
I'm reading the book.
Joe handed it to me after we stopped recording last week. And I literally.
I did not hand it to you.
Yeah, you said I have Gucci's book and you handed it to me. That's how I got it in my hand.
After you said, let me see?
No. You said, hey, I got this from the desk of today. Look.
All right, I want to hear the part about how it got to Jersey City then.
Oh, because I asked. Once
hey, since I'm taking all the blame here, let me hear how it ended up on Bergen.
Because I wanted to, after I read, I opened the book to this page, read this out loud, and yeah, I want to read the book now. It's a fucking phenomenal book.
And I'm in agreement with you. I concur. Me and Ian hate that word, concur. But fucking, and because it was such an amazing paragraph, Rory with the dramatic Gucci read.
This is page 96 of the autobiography of Gucci Man. The advanced, uncorrected proofs, not for sale copy.
Soft cover. Pause.
Gucci Man was a murder suspect. Moments earlier, I'd been on such a high, proud of myself, and the rug had been pulled from under me.
Jacob took a flight back to Atlanta, but I drove back with Throw, Ace, and my security guard. We wanted to avoid a scene at the airport in case the police tried to scoop me there. On board so far.
That's smart, Gucci.
Makes a lot of sense.
I'm with you.
That was a long and quiet drive. We stopped in New Jersey to pick up weed and get White Castle burgers. That was the first time eating White Castle. Then we headed home.
Stop right there. Stop right there. Let me interject. There's no way Gucci first time eating White Castle burgers and right after that he didn't say and I almost shit myself. Talking about we went home. Continue.
Wait.
That's why you went home.
Well, they don't have White Castle in Atlanta, do they?
No. Nah, they only got it up here, but still. I don't know why that was mentioned.
Okay. White Castle.
He better shit himself somewhere in this next paragraph. Well, he lying.
I didn't make it to exit 12 without shitting myself. I was smoking like a chimney the whole ride. We were burning so much that we had to find more weed by the time we reached Washington, D.C. We also made a little...
Wait, didn't they just buy the weed at exit 12?
Go ahead, man. Just read it. All right, fine.
We also made it a point to stop at a few strip clubs on the way and fuck some hoes, too.
Smart. Smart, Gucci.
When you're on the run for murder.
Makes sense to stop and fuck some hoes.
No, they made it a point.
Yeah. Smart. I'm fucking with Gucci so far.
But all that was a diversion from my reality of the situation. Damn. I was sitting there in the back seat of that smoke-filled sedan, high as a jaybird.
It's a what?
A jaybird? Why does Gucci man know the bird family? Wait, which one is a J? That's not a team. I know the Cardinals. The Jaybirds. What the fuck? What sport is that? That nigga watching some other shit. All right.
I was sitting there in the backseat of the smoke-filled sedan, high as a Jaybird, with John Legend's Ordinary People playing over and over and over again. That was my favorite song at the time.
I mean, that is a great song, Gucci.
Great song.
I'm not mad at you so far.
My nerves grew as we approached Georgia, knowing what awaited me. Let's run, Throw, I said. Let's hide out in Alabama. You can't run, bro, he laughed. You're too famous now. But don't worry. We'll beat this. I wasn't so sure. Not a lot of people have walked away from murder charges where I come from. When we got to Atlanta, we drove straight to DeKalb County Jail. In the parking lot, I met my attorney. Can we beat it? I asked. Part of me still wanted to run for it. It's going to take a lot, he said, but we can beat it.
The end. Ladies and gentlemen.
Rich Dollars, he might be Gwinnie.
Rich is Gwinnie. All right, so, great allegedly, word. Nicki Minaj goes to the studio 105 to fuck with Clue. They're from Queens, you know what I mean? They got that Queens Bond shit happening. She goes to fuck with Clue. At the end of the shit, Clue is asking for drops because that's what you do at radio stations. Clue allegedly asked her to do a drop for Self, and that's when she had enough. Enough was enough at that point. So she didn't do the drop, and nope, the world would have never known a thing, but they had to take it to Twitter. I really love people who take things to Twitter that we would have never known about.
Don't ever stop
everybody takes
giving your personal business out there so we can laugh.
Yeah, but sometimes they take things that they shouldn't take. Like, that could have been a real sacred moment in Power 105.
For sure.
Now it's in our hands. For sure. And we mean none of them any good. So this is excellent. So they go to Twitter. I'm just going to read what DJ Self has to say. DJ Self said... And I quote. Oh, I don't have it.
You're not quoting.
Oh, here it is. And I quote. Took this to the gram.
He starts with that?
No. That's the platform he chose.
All right.
He said, well, there you have it. I never asked for a hug or a drop. Truth is, I said hi. She said hi back. Never knew she had an issue with me. We only speak when she has a project coming, so by that, I know what my relationship is with her. Clue asked her to do a drop for DJ Self, and she declined, which I wasn't in the room. Why would she not? I have no clue.
Whoa, double entendre.
Yeah, don't even ask him how. He goes on to say, because I'm friends with Safari? ? Or Dream Doll? Who knows?
I'm just trying to move the culture here in New York. If you're not with that wave, all right, I don't care about your political bullshit. If you're not with that wave, please stay far away from me. And that's very corny to me to have an issue with a person who you have no relationship with and to beef with me to reality hole the same week your album drops. That's what Self says. Mm-hmm. Self thinks that Nicki Minaj is maybe using him for promotional purposes.
Yeah. No, that go.
What I will say is Self is a
I don't
weird,
know if I'm rolling Self.
Well, yeah, I'm not rolling with that one either, Self. Who beefs with Self? So there's more to this somehow. Nicki replied, she said he's mad because I refuse to give him a drop or a hug. See, she think we stupid. Come on, Mom. Like, I'm with you. You can't defend this. He mad because I refused to give him a drop or a hug. He was just up there dissing the bitch, thinking that would make me fuck with him. LMAO. Joke's on you once again. All right, first of all, I'm not doing this any justice. He mad because I refused to give him a drop or a hug. He was just there dissing the bitch, thinking that would make me fuck with him. LMAO. Joke's on you once again, dummy. Passed up on your meal. Passed up on your meal? Oh, your meal ticket. Oh.
That's a shot with the Cardi situation.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. Passed up on your meal ticket. Now you get crumbs from her table. You a reality TV hoe. Used to be a respected DJ. Mm. When was Self respect? Yeah. No, he was.
No, he was. He did well.
He was.
At one point, his slap no, was really well.
He was tearing the clubs up. Yeah. And his ratings were doing well. We not here to shit on Self. Self
no,
was
no,
great.
No, no,
Maul, do we believe that Self was mad that he didn't get a drop or a hug from Nicki Minaj? Come on, Maul.
Well, a drop, a hug. Yeah. I believe he was mad at the drop. Her saying no to the drop. The hug, no. Nah, I don't think the hug, no.
Did he ask it, like, where's my hug
but
at?
I think him not getting the drop was more of a reason for him to be like, damn, like, you don't fuck with me? Like, what I do to you? Oh, because I'm cool with Safari?
But why would she, if his opinion is Cardi's album is better than Nicki's, and that's the rumor, mm-hmm. that's why all of this really happened, why he can't just have that opinion? Like, why does she have to lash out at him about it? No, why can't you do the drop?
That's what she does.
why, like...
Well, if she don't fuck with him...
Well, yeah, I'm not... Yeah.
Saying,
if she's not going to hug him, she's not going to give him
the
drop.
He's saying that it's because of him being cool with Safari. That's what he thinks. So if she not fucking with nobody that's cool with Safari, I mean, that's, you know...
If she made you pick, what are you taking? The hug? Or the drop?
The hug.
Me?
Yeah.
I don't know how much a hug will do.
She looked like she smelled good.
She goes on to say, where my hug at? Where my hug face ass nigga? Dissing another female rapper won't make me like you. You hold no weight in this city. Nigga, look at your roster. I did Clue Show, and he was up there looking like a sad kid asking for a drop, trying to get a hug. I won't give you a drop. You're not a DJ, ho.
That hug is holding a lot of weight, man.
No, wait, she said you're not
Jesus
a DJ
Christ.
Hoe?
Yeah.
Or you're not a DJ, you're a hoe.
She wants to have fire hugs.
I think there was
it's no comma, it's just caps. DJ and hoe and caps.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah.
Implied comma.
All right, she goes on to say, why you wait till I leave? I got some hungry niggas with me, bitch. I'll be back tomorrow.
Energy.
I like that.
You like her telling DJ Self that she has hungry niggas with her and they'll be back to the radio station tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Maul.
I like that energy.
Will they still be hungry tomorrow?
That's the hip hop I come from.
I was going to say, that's 01 right there.
That's the cloth I'm from right there.
The cloth.
That's all I like. That.
Shooting people outside Hot 97.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah.
She goes on to say, you was just dissing her. LOL. You will remain bitter and broke looking for scraps at VH1. You love my album and just said how it's the best thing ever.
Was that a quote?
This is all from her. You hoes way too emotional.
All right.
She said that. I'm glad I ain't give your hoe ass no drop and no hug.
Why does she keep calling this grown man a hoe?
Say it to a real nigga face, hoe.
Why is Nicki calling a grown man a hoe?
Why does she keep forcing the hug currency?
Mom.
Holy shit. Yo, calling a grown man a hoe is hilarious, man. You hoe. Imagine you get into an argument with a girl and she call you a hoe.
More than once.
I don't have to imagine.
I feel like
that's happened to everybody.
That is hilarious. I like that.
I can't believe you're supporting that.
The hoe? Calling a dude a hoe is funny. I don't. All of this shit is for laughs for me. I don't give a fuck. But calling a man a hoe is funny.
And then Mariah Lynn chimed in.
All right. Mariah Lynn chimed in. Jersey City.
Talk
what,
about it.
What? Added Nicki Minaj. Let's cock a gun. Let's fire. Nah, don't get scared now, mom.
Don't get scared.
Mariah said, hey, add Nicki Minaj. What type of hoe time are you on?
Can we get a hoe count?
Crazy how you disrespecting a man who has helped so many people to advance and elevate their career. But I can't think of one single person that you have. Wait, she says, career. One single person that you have. I've heard stories from Safari, but now I see for myself, you a real life corny ass bitch. The same way you said if Drizzy say get her, well, self don't even got to say that.
Well, hold on. I'm not going to let you get that off. You can't even say that in my presence. I'm not going to let you get that off. I'm sorry. She did not say that corny bullshit, my nigga. She did not say that corny bullshit.
First of all, can you stop
what?
Hating? Can you stop hating?
My bad.
I'm trying to finish.
All right, go ahead.
Listen, I'm going to repeat that one. Oh, that's like a, what is it that the Hitman Holler be doing? I'm going to bring it back. I'm going to rewind this one.
Oh, I just dissed you.
She said.
Slow it down.
The same way you said if Drizzy say get her, .. That's important. Well, self don't even got to say that. I am always on go for him. Oh. That was on Instagram. Then she went to Snapchat with it.
I'm sure she
did. Oh, God.
I don't give a fuck who you are. Do not come for self. If you are a female, because I will have something to say. He has done so much good for so many people. I refuse to allow him to be belittled or his character be defamed in any way, shape, or form. Period.
Kobe, KD, Kyrie,
pick a K. How come every time I play it, none of y'all pick a K?
I picked a K the first time you played it.
But no, that's how you, you're a Laker fan, fuck out of here. That's how you know, come on, why she said that line like, come on, Maul.
Because Laura Ben Cross.
Who has ever tried to decide between Kobe,
you have to pick
Kyrie, and Kevin Durant? Was that a play on all the mics? Like, K? Tell me when you went in the barbershop and heard a nigga say, all right, who's the illest K?
What's your top five K?
Who's the best K ever? Nah, dead ass.
Kyle Korver.
Double K.
That's two Ks. Come on, my nigga.
Kobe, KD, Kyrie, pick a K.
Look, the delay. The delay.
I love the Kyrie punching.
Wait, she dropped the beat out and delayed Kyrie. Come on, Mom.
Kobe, KD, Kyrie,
pick a K.
Yo, no, Parks, no. Anytime a producer, when y'all put this.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's climbing. Oh, we in our bag now. Ganja burn.
Oh, shit. Just like Drizzy said.
What?
Yeah. If you don't put your phone back in your pocket.
Oh, wait. No, there was more. DJ Self, Mariah says, I guess we are trending. I'll always be loyal to you to the very end and no threats.
I guess
or
we are trending.
My mom. Would you shut the fuck up?
This era is
Would you stop, man? I will be loyal to you to the very end. And no threats or comment can ever change that. I don't give a fuck about people's opinions because I have more loyalty in my pinky than they have in their entire bodies.
Mm. That's a lot of loyalty.
Nobody asked pinky. For her opinion.
Could be a very big pinky.
Mariah, she looks pinky as not even that big, though. Or,
like. Yeah. She didn't think
she
that bar
thumb at least.
Yeah. There's not a lot of loyalty in her pinky. No. This is a great beef. Yeah. Wait.
And we're not even to the nitty gritty yet.
Wait. Then Dream Dog chimes in.
Naturally.
And Dream Dog said, I'm not even looking for what she said, but she said, yo, I'm going to keep it a buck.
Oh boy. No one ever keeps it a buck.
I'm telling you what
a
she said.
A buck don't even get you anything.
No, she was keeping it a buck. She said, yo, I'm gonna keep it a buck. Karen Civil FaceTimed self and said, you wanna know why you didn't get that drop from Nicki Minaj? Dream Doll. That's what Dream Doll Instagram. That she's the
any
reason.
More information or just ended on that?
Well, then Karen chimed in.
Oh, God.
And then Karen said, look, bitch, y'all keep my name out of all that shit. Even if I said that shit, I'm not going to agree that I said it now. Like, duh, the fuck is wrong with you? Even if I said that now, no. And keep me out your mess, because you messy. I was trying to support you. Maul, I was saying to Rory that when her last album came out, that back then I was saying that she probably shouldn't spend so much energy and focus on Safari on release week because she was doing that last album. Mm. And now here we are with this album, and she's back on Safari. I don't know how it always ends up back on Safari. But wait, I'm defending Safari. So you know what my beef be with women? And it don't even be women in they emo breakup, talking to my ex bag, getting some shit off my chest. I'm not mad at that. I get mad at the other women who now come and support it, right? Mm. Let me just read you a few tweets that Nicki Minaj retweeted when I was home trying to figure out why Safari was such a hot topic for her. The first one she retweeted says, I hate women. I guess Nicki is fed up. I feel her. Ain't nothing like having to stay silent and listen to bums spread lies about you. The next one says, why is it that everyone can have an opinion on Nicki and it be okay because it's an opinion, but when she claps back, she's messy, bitter, and insecure? No? Glad sis got that off her chest. Yes, Onika, we live for the moment of truth. No one can take that away from you.
No one can take that away from her.
Come on.
Somebody got to take away these people's thoughts and her mentions. I don't know what people are thinking,
man. All right, well, let me tell you what.
What do you want me to do?
Well, no, let me tell you what Minaj Dev said.
Okay. Minaj Dev. Okay.
I'm sure he was really objective.
Minaj Dev said, she took shit for years. Bet not a single bitch have a problem with her standing up for herself. These niggas literally tried to destroy her career. Credibility. It's dragon season. Period.
It's dragon season. It's
Safari
dragon
season. Was home minding his business. Yo, somebody explain. No, come on. Safari was home, nigga.
He might have been.
He
might have been. I don't know what he's doing.
He was home.
You would know before.
He was definitely not on
that mall. That's your guy. He might have spoke to him. I don't know.
He was home shooting the Bumbaclot video that's coming.
That's true.
Yeah.
Right.
Why is she giving this nigga all this energy? I'm here for all of this. My sis was minding her business, living her best life for years, while everyone talked shit. Now she's back, and she ain't lifting her foot up. Don't fuck it up. Oh, don't fuck if it don't apply, whatever. Do I need to go on more? I hate when women try to support other women.
It's a bad sound. Because
listen to this. Listen, I'm trying to pull up the Safari shit. I'm not pulling up the Safari shit. I'm going straight to Nicki shit, because this caused quite the stir up in our group chat. Nicki says here, and she's talking about Safari, she says, you stole my card and told me you thought it was an account with free money that I didn't know about. On God.
Swag.
God will strike you down and more for lying. Ha! Stop saying you packed and left. On Jesus, you came to my house crying, begging to go with me to Europe, to the EMAs. I said no, dummy.
Why she wouldn't take him to Europe?
Get out of here, Safari.
After he paid for hookers, like
I'm going to the EMAs.
You can't prove that.
You can't ride. Sharika and I had a bet that soon as you knew Meek was about to come home, you'd crawl back, and you did. You did.
she doubled up when
came
he
to my house crying. Joyce was there.
Why was Joyce there?
What was Joyce doing?
Joyce is chilling.
Joyce somewhere right now, like, why?
Nah, Joyce was like, I remember that day.
but why am I lying?
Joyce was there. My whole glam was there. Left who? You getting aired out on Queen Radio 2, Thursdays, 9 o'clock.
No.
The plug.
Nah, man.
No, she didn't say 9 o'clock.
Okay, I was about to say, nah, she didn't do that.
But it's the same shit. Why does she have a radio show right now, too? I want to rewind really quickly because I missed this very important one here. When Safari said, yo, how was I begging to go to Europe with you and you were in a full-blown relationship towards the end of ours? That's when you still want that old thing back. Like, you still searching for answers and closure. Shut up, nigga. I knew it was a wrap. No, you didn't. I still have the email when you hit me saying, let's spend Christmas together and work things out. So please stop. That's what Safari said. Like, you could tell still a little bit of love there. Like, he tried
you
know, to...
You're being mad biased right now. You screamed as Nicki. Now Safari got, like, the low, deep,
and
low
Safari
voice.
Has never had that low, cool voice before.
So Nicki replied and said, bitch, you hit me and Meek asking us to get your dick pic back from someone. LOL. You were playing with your dick in the shower by yourself with suds and shit. I have the email where you said you couldn't pay your electric bill and why you lied on me. But go off, sis.
That's so many individual thoughts.
Yo, why is Nicki calling grown men ho and sis, man?
Wait, that's what you grabbed out of that?
I want to know why.
Yeah, all that other shit. With suds, all that other shit, I don't care about a nigga masturbating with suds. Like, I'm not talking about that. All
right.
But what is the truth? What is a lie?
I just don't understand how you say asking to get the dick pic back.
Was it a physical copy?
That will be the only way you can get
and
a dick pic back.
And this is after breakup. So Nicki was fucking with Meek already. So when she was talking to Safari, I'm sure she was giving him that energy like, of I got a new nigga, get off my dick. So they was beefing already, and then they probably hung up on each other. And then a couple minutes went by, and then Safari called back.
And Meek
answered. Another thing! One more thing!
I can't see. That goes back.
One more thing, and then everything would be straight! Nicki, you and Meek, we are not straight right now.
Yo, that accent is trash.
One more thing, Nick. Another thing.
Is Meek there too? I want him to hear this.
Put this on speaker. Omika, Meek and Nicki, both of you. I sent this pic out.
Help me.
She's not really kicking it to me, but she's a huge fan of both of you guys. Love the single you guys got together. If you guys could just get that dick pic back for me.
I'll greatly appreciate
and
it.
And email it. Email, I love your mom. Tell your mom's hi.
Holy shit.
Get the dick pic back.
Wait. He said... Because this is what's funny. He said, first off, me and Tiger didn't go to the same doctor. We did it the same day, different doctors. Okay. Clarity.
But why? Tiger's somewhere like, fam, I'm still rolling with my shit as official. Like,
nah, but you know what's fucked up? Tiger's been having a great year. That's what's fucked up.
They're just using Tiger.
And if
for
they
clout.
Went to the same doctor, Safari got a way better job than Tiger. Tiger's shit still look a little toupee-ish.
They showed the before and after, and Tiger shit was definitely way crispier. His shit was like back here. And that guy brought it to, like, here.
Then what happened?
They put a whole piece of hair on his head.
Oh, that nigga looks great. That nigga looked like he'd been letting the ganja burn, ganja burn, ganja burn.
Yo, man. You're with him all the time.
That's true.
I like Safari.
I know. I just said that's your man. You killing
well,
me for.
Time out. I don't like Safari in furs. I don't like Safari in Dykeman. I don't like Safari replying to Nicki Minaj. There's a few instances where I don't like people. Mm-hmm. Like, that's when I try to stay away. Whenever people are doing some shit that I know I don't like them for.
You just tried to call
them
twice.
The funny shit about this is it's coming from you. And if we look at your past history and shit that you've been through. So for you saying, I don't like that.
It's already been. I've been exonerated.
No, you haven't.
Your honus was not deleted.
Yeah, your
Trina.
Honus don't get deleted.
Well, I don't think it was a hoe.
It's what? A figure of speech.
Okay.
Maul just gave you the squint eyes.
I know, I can't talk about nothing that happened on tour.
No, I think
he could squint eye at me, but I can't. You know what I mean? Squint again, nigga. Squint again.
I was thinking.
What do you better?
I was
yeah,
to think
fix
about
the squint.
You're saying that you're not a hoe. Like, okay.
Yeah, but fix the squint, my nigga. I was on tour.
What is that? I don't care about you talking about anything about me, Joe Budden. What do you mean? I'm not scared of you saying
that. Why are you saying my own name?
That, you say your name all the time. This is Joe Budden.
I'm asking you why you are saying my name.
I'm telling you that I don't care if you say
no, about... we come from the era where full name meant something more. Come on. What's up?
Because
there's a door behind you.
No, because you're saying you've been exonerated. So I'm saying you haven't.
I have been exonerated.
No, you haven't. Not yet. You would have to like go to like see Mother Teresa or something.
Listen, all that shit from my past where I was wilding, those was all the very dark days where I was letting a ganja burn, ganja burn, ganja burn. I don't care what you say. All right, I'm off the fart now. I don't care about the fart.
Hey, no pressure. Never graduated, but I school him like professor. Growing up, the world always told me I was lesser. Growing up, the world told me I could not address her. Gangsters put that heat to your head like a hairdresser. If you press an issue on they block. This liquor that I'm drinking got me thinking about some other shit. Feeling like I'm sinking like Titanic or some other ship. Word to your mothership. Boy, that's that gutter shit. Breaking down the weed to get high as Thomas and Kyle.